Do you want to know if you're insulin resistant using test results that you already have? If you have a recent cholesterol test, there is a formula you can input your numbers into that is a really strong indicator of insulin resistance. And this is important because the reality is most people are insulin resistant and don't know it. And it can explain a lot of the common health struggles so many of us deal with. Difficulty losing weight, excess belly fat, high blood pressure, low blood sugar after eating, poor sleep. It even causes skin tags. By knowing we are insulin resistant, we can start making changes and reversing the condition, because insulin resistance is reversible, as are the associated symptoms. But if we leave it unaddressed, it will eventually lead to prediabetes, type 2 diabetes, heart disease, and more. So if you're wondering if you're insulin resistant, keep watching. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a certified health and nutrition coach. I post videos here on YouTube twice a week talking all things insulin resistance, weight loss, sleep, and more. So if you're ready to take control of your metabolic health, make sure to click that subscribe button. And you can also find me on TikTok and Instagram where I share new posts every single day. Now, if you aren't too sure what causes insulin resistance, because a lot of people aren't, I'm not gonna go too into that today. But basically, it's when the cells in our body are no longer responding to insulin correctly. They're not taking in glucose or sugar from the bloodstream as they should. So more insulin has to be produced in order to keep your blood sugar at baseline. And while your fasting blood sugar might be normal, your insulin is high, and it is high circulating insulin that leads to the associated symptoms and diseases. If you want to know more about the cause of insulin resistance, I'm gonna link a video up above. Now we're gonna get right into the formula you can use with your cholesterol numbers. That's a really strong indicator for insulin resistance. But I just wanna say that there are specific tests you can ask your doctor for if you wanna be entirely certain. However, a lot of doctors won't run these tests because they think that looking at fasting blood glucose, fasting blood sugar is enough, that this is a stronger indicator of our metabolic health and our risk for diabetes and heart disease. But insulin resistance and high insulin starts years before fasting blood sugar starts to rise. So it really isn't enough. But anyways, I'll talk more about those tests you can ask your doctor for after. Right now, let's get into the formula. Now, the numbers you want to be looking for on your cholesterol test are your triglycerides and your HDL. We're going to be finding the ratio between the two by dividing your triglycerides by your HDL. Now you really need to make sure that your numbers are in milligrams per deciliter. If they're in millimoles per liter, the ratio is not gonna work out. If your test results are in millimoles per liter, then you want to multiply your triglycerides by 89 and you want to multiply your HDL by 39 and then calculate the ratio. A ratio under 1.9 is considered optimal. This is a good indicator that you're insulin sensitive. Between 2 and 3 indicates some insulin resistance, and anything above 3 is significant insulin resistance. And this ratio has been shown to be a very strong indicator of insulin resistance and heart disease risk, independent of how high or low your LDL cholesterol is. So don't look at LDL at all. It really isn't a strong indicator of anything. Triglycerides and HDL, these are a lot more telling. Now, there is one catch to this formula. If you have already started making changes to address your insulin resistance, if you have started eating a low-carb diet, if you've started intermittent fasting, if you've started taking apple cider vinegar before your meals, if you've cut out snacking, if you're taking walks after your meals, when you start making these changes, your triglycerides and your HDL improve rapidly. Your triglycerides drop and your HDL increases, improving your ratio. And that's the catch here. If you've already started making these changes, then your ratio might appear to be good, but you still could be insulin resistant. So if you have a blood panel from before you started making changes, take a look at that and calculate your ratio. If it has improved, you're gonna know that you're heading in the right direction. Now, this method is a really strong indicator, but there obviously are some flaws, which I just spoke about. Dr. Ben Bickman, who is a lead researcher in the field of insulin resistance, he calls this method the poor man's method for testing for insulin resistance. If you want to know 100% how insulin resistant or insulin sensitive you are, you need to have your fasting insulin tested. The test you want to have is a HOMA-IR test, which is the gold standard for insulin resistance. This tests your fasting insulin and your fasting blood sugar. This tells you how much insulin your body needs to keep your fasting blood sugar within a healthy range. So you can have what is considered to be a normal or healthy fasting blood sugar. But if your insulin is really high, that shows that it's taking a lot of insulin to keep your blood sugar in check, which signifies insulin resistance. And this is why this test catches insulin resistance years before it progresses to prediabetes or type 2 diabetes, because ultimately that's where it's gonna go if you leave it unaddressed. There's gonna become a point where the excess insulin that your body's creating just can't keep up any longer with your blood sugar. Now, you can ask your doctor to run a HOMA-IR test or even just a fasting insulin test. And if they're up to date with the current literature and if they're up to date with the importance of insulin and the significance of insulin resistance, then they should run it for you. But unfortunately, a lot of doctors aren't. Now, if you are in this situation and your doctor's not gonna run the test for you, there is one company who has an at-home kit that tests fasting insulin and calculates your HOMA-IR score. This test is only available in the United States. This is the Weight Biology Kit from SoWell Health. Along with fasting insulin and fasting blood sugar and HOMA-IR, it also tests other key biomarkers of metabolic health. So it really gives you a full picture of where you're at. All it takes is a couple finger pricks to get a sample. You send it back, and within a couple of days, you're gonna get your results reviewed by a physician, and you're gonna receive a report that gives you next steps you can take. I highly recommend this if you're having trouble getting the test from your doctor. I'm gonna put the link in the description box down below, and you can use code KATE10 to save 10% off your order. And I love this kit because not only does it tell you where you're currently at, but it also allows you to track your progress and see how the changes you are making, see the impact that they're having. So let me know in the comment section down below what your triglyceride to HDL ratio is. Have you already started making changes? Could this be impacting your results? Let me know down below. I love chatting with you guys in the comment section. If you did enjoy this video, you might also enjoy my video on how to improve insulin sensitivity. You can check it out here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my coaching programs, including my 7-day insulin resistance masterclass that includes a 7-day meal plan, you can check that out here. Thanks guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.